Spray drift reducing technology comes in many forms. In part one of our report, we looked at the wind tunnel research taking place at Gatton. In this second part, we'll look at some of the other developments in drift reducing technology. Aircraft play a big part in agricultural chemical application. A plane like this can cost about $1 million, so it's in an operator's interest to equip it with best practice technology. Attached below the wing is a rotating spray boom, which allows the pilot to change spray droplet size in flight by using angle and air pressure.
We create a different droplet size by putting the angle of the nozzle into the slipstream that the aeroplane generates, about 250 kilometres an hour. So if the nozzle's pointing straight back, you're creating a large droplet, and if it's pointing down, the shatter causes a very fine droplet, which you might use for insecticides.
Supporting the technology is a quality assurance program and minimum standards for swath width, droplet size and water volumes, something Peter Travers hopes the regulators can start to take into consideration.
If a buffer zone is on the label, then we must comply with it. And buffer zones have been calculated using worst case scenarios. So even though we've introduced this technology, we haven't got any credit from the regulators. We still have to follow the buffers that are shown on the label.
Ground spray application equipment with improved drift reducing technology was also on display. This boom spray rig was hauled almost 2,000 kilometres from Adelaide to Gatton just for an hour's demonstration of its auto-levelling capability.
A typical auto-height system has sensors out on the wings that measure the ground and can adjust that wing to suit the level of the ground to keep it at a certain point. But it's generally controlled by the level of the tractor. This system is independent to the machine now, so the boom can do whatever it wants and however it has to do it to keep itself level.
Looking on was US research scientist Holger Tank, who works for the Dow Chemical Company. His expertise is developing new formulations, and most recently that's meant including drift reducing technology into those formulations.
Really to understand where opportunities are for this type of technologies, and particularly here with the workshop, trying to understand how this would be seen by the regulatory authorities, how they would actually recognize the drift reduction technology that is built into a formulation versus like nozzle technology or tank mix additives or so.
Local scientists too were positive about the Gatton field trip and the three-day DRT workshop.
We're doing a lot of groundbreaking work here in Australia, but there's also a lot of groundbreaking work in other countries. And through the coming together of Europe, America, Australia, New Zealand this week, we've been able to learn from each other how we can improve our spray process and understanding the spray process. I think from a regulatory point of view, Australia is now able to look at the schemes in other countries and what the implications are of those schemes on Australia, and now make a much better judgment on what will work here, and more importantly, what won't work.
What the National Working Party for Pesticide Applications had set out to do was give regulators the opportunity to meet researchers and developers of drift-reducing technologies. Gavin Katanak believes it will make a difference.
I'm quietly confident that the regulator has understood the concerns of farmers and they're working on a system that will be much fairer but still protect the wider environment, and they have to do that. That's their job.
GRDC has already provided $1 million for DRT research, and another million has been allocated for future support, especially into development of drift-reducing technologies that help improve the on-target efficacy of sprays. As well as the technical information the visiting regulators were given, the opportunity to see and discuss the technology can only improve the likelihood of a positive outcome for all parties with an interest in DRTs and spray buffer zones.